My name is Billy Riggs, and I am not merely an illusionist. I am what I call a dis-illusionist, which means I don't get nearly as excited about performing my illusions as I do about getting into your head and exposing your illusions, damaging psychological illusions that harden into glass ceilings in your head and form self-imposed barriers to success. Let me give you a simple and familiar example. I assume most of you have seen the nine-dot puzzle before. It's been around for 100 years. I remember having fun with it as a kid. The challenge is to draw 4 straight lines without picking up your pencil and manage to connect all 9 dots. And it's really hard because it seems that any way that you do it, it requires 5 lines, not 4. But as it turns out, that's only because we all tend to bring a self-imposed limitation, a rule to the game that was never stated or intended. We assume that it is forbidden to draw outside the lines. We start with the assumption that we dare not go outside the perimeter of those 9 dots. In other words, your subconscious mind rules out any possible solution to the problem before you even begin to think about it. And it renders what should be a very simple and straightforward problem not just complicated, but literally impossible. So what do? You get yourself disillusioned. You shatter all of those self-imposed limitations. Do you think it's possible to connect those 9 dots with 3 straight lines without picking up your pencil? The answer is yeah. It just needs a bigger box. You have to think farther outside the box. Now, right now you're saying, oh yeah, but you never told us that it was okay not to go through the center of the dot. And you're right. You added that rule with no help from me whatsoever. Let's take it up another notch. Could you possibly connect these dots with 2 straight lines, never picking up your pencil? Yeah. Now you're saying, well, you didn't tell us you could use a really thick line. Exactly. You added the rule all on your own, which kept you from solving the puzzle. It keeps you from solving life's problems, too. You just need a pencil the size of a baseball bat. And in your head, you're saying, but there's no such thing as a pencil the size of a baseball bat. Then go make one. Now you're way ahead of me. Let's take it up another notch. Is it possible to connect all 9 dots with 1 line? Of course. You just need a pencil the size of a telephone pole. I would like to share with you what I call the stages of innovation. But if you like, you can call it the stages of success, the stages of creativity, because it's all pretty well tightly wrapped and bundled together. Over here on the left side, on the vertical y-axis, we have your mood. This is the way that you're feeling about life or a particular project. Way down at the bottom is depression, way at the top is elation. On the horizontal x-axis, that tracks your progress toward the goal. On the left, you haven't even started. On the far right end, you've completed it. This is the way that projects tend to go down. You start by thinking, it's brilliant. This is a wonderful idea. This is gonna take the world by storm. So you start to work on it eagerly, and then all of a sudden, you hit a couple of speed bumps. And maybe then you run into a wall, and maybe the wall starts to hit back, and then you start to think, it's complicated. This is a lot harder than I thought it was going to be. I'm not sure I can pull this off. You begin to have doubts. You begin to get a little bit discouraged, and then you reach the bottom, and you throw in the towel, and you say, it's hopeless, it's useless. And then, at this critical third step, right at the bottom of the curve, it is a very short drop, but a predictable one. If you're not careful, you move from it's hopeless to I'm hopeless. I'm a loser. I just can't get it done. I'm pond scum. I'm a boil on the buttock of life. I'm toe jam in the body of humanity. I would write a book on failure if I wasn't sure it would fail. And from there, if you give in to that, it's a predictable one. That's where you crash and you burn. But it doesn't have to be that way, because you can change things by shifting your attitude right here at the bottom of the curve. Instead of saying it's hopeless and I'm hopeless, you say, it's really hard, but I am determined to make it happen. You change your outlook. This reminds me of Thomas Edison trying to invent the light bulb. He spent years trying to find a filament that would burn for more than a few seconds. A reporter asked him one time, Mr. Edison, how does it feel to have failed 10,000 times to invent the electric light bulb? You know what he replied? He reportedly said, I don't look at it that way at all. In my mind, I have successfully found 10,000 ways that it won't work. and it's just a matter of time before I find the right hand. And it was shortly after the 10,000th element he tried that suddenly the electric light bulb was blurred. You see, if you persist, if you're really hard, if you have the right attitude, the right outlook, you begin to make a turn, and you start to have some success, and you think in the back of your mind, well, maybe this is going to work after all. And then at the top, you say to yourself,